Welcome back to Paul's Tech News. Everyone expected that this week the tech news would be awesome, but it turns out it actually all sucks. Or possibly the other way around. The point is, AMD has confused us all with mysterious leaks about products that were supposedly impossible or impractical to make. Intel was nearing collapse, but thankfully now the president has inserted himself into the proceedings, so surely that will all be smoothed over and just become another minor distraction. And perhaps the most devastating news this week is the now public fact that next week, like it or not, there will be no tech news. The show will return the week after, so let's all just chill for a while and make sure nothing noteworthy or eventful happens in the interim. An uneventful week in 2025 is a bit overdue after all, so on with the tech news.
Excellent!
Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware Store on paulshardware.net, the only official source for Paul's Hardware merchandise. Tantalizing t-shirts, brilliant beer sets, high-quality hoodies, and more, all featuring the classic thumbscrew for tasteful and refined viewers, or the 8-bit thumbscrew for tasteful and refined viewers who hate curves. New designs are added sporadically and at random, so head over to paulshardware.net and get some of that sweet, sweet merch right now. Or not right now, after you watch the video. Either way. We have much need of haste today. There's a schedule to keep, so the entire show will be presented tech briefs style, now with more room in the crotch. Let's begin with AMD and a story I haven't covered much up to now. Currently, the best AMD Radeon GPU is the RX 9070 XT 16GB, and there have been rumors bandied about for some time that there might be a 32GB variant of that card. Back at Computex, AMD revealed the Radeon AI PRO R9700, which is basically a 32GB RX 9070 XT, as it uses the same Navi 48 die, albeit in Pro workstation trim and with that nice doubled up VRAM setup. It was supposed to launch in late July but has been MIA, but now it appears that the first round of sales went to system integrators per this landing page put up by XFX, who doesn't usually make workstation cards, but apparently they want in on that AI gravy train as they're promoting quad GPU setups with 128GB total VRAM, like this one. It's unclear why AMD originally said they wouldn't be mass producing the reference design for this card, but these are clearly the made by AMD blower style coolers originally shared at Computex. They are expected to be made available for direct sale, possibly later in Q3, but pricing is still unknown and no independent benchmarks have been published either. It will be very interesting to see how the Radeon AI PRO R9700 stacks up against an RTX 5070, 5070 Ti, or 5080 in situations where even 16GB of VRAM isn't enough. Continuing the AMD news, existing AM5 PC owners were devastated this week when details for AMD's next-gen socket AM6 started to leak out, as reported by Bits and Chips. It's still a rumor, but AM6 will purportedly feature 2100 pins, 22% more than AM5's 1718, while maintaining the same socket size for compatibility with existing CPU coolers, which is definitely appreciated. This info is backed up by patent filings and illustrations that are already public, but WCCF Tech pointed out that these patent images actually appear to be socket SP5 from back in 2022. So as with all leaked info, take this with a grain of salt. The AM6 platform is expected to support PCIe Gen 6, DDR6, and CPUs based on Zen 7 microarchitecture, so aforementioned AM5 owners still have a couple years prior to inevitable obsolescence. Ryzen 10,000 series CPUs based on the Zen 6 architecture are expected in 2026 still, and the new AM6 platform will probably launch in 2027. Thankfully, AMD seems to be sticking with a sane and sequential numerical sequence for AM6, and they haven't added AI anywhere. Yet. Getting back to the current generation of CPUs, here's an AMD mystery to solve. We all know Ryzen CPUs with 3D V-Cache are the optimum choice for gaming PCs. An extra 64 megabytes of cache per CCD, now stacked below the die with Zen 5 for better cooling, minimizes latency to squeeze maximum frames from a GPU. But the main beneficiary of this technology so far has been gaming, and AMD has long claimed that having more than one 3D V-Cache enabled CCD in a CPU, like you'd need with 12 or 16 core variants, is too expensive and kills that gaming bonus due to latency between the CCDs. So why is hardware leaker ChiliDog claiming new Zen 5 Granite Ridge desktop CPUs are in the works, including a 16-core 200-watt processor with 192 megabytes of L3 cache? That almost certainly means double the V-cache, but how? Two 3D V-cache CCDs? Did AMD somehow solve that latency problem? Are they doing a double stack of V-cache on a single CCD? Will it be called the 9950X 3D Extreme Edition, or the 9999X 3D, or the 9950X 3 Double D? So many questions. If you guys have answers, let me know in the comments. Coincidentally though, that AMD double V-cache leak dropped in quick succession after similar Intel news surfaced regarding BLLC, or Big Last Level Cache, which is Team Blue's answer to 3D V-cache, or so it is said. Now whether there's any secret coordination happening with Chippel forum posts and leaked info is undetermined, but per video cards, Intel's roadmap was recently updated to include a new CPU with more than 200 megabytes of cache, or a double BLLC, whereas a single BLLC version topped out at 140 megabytes. Interesting, but not imminent, as BLLC isn't expected to arrive for consumers until Intel launches Nova Lake in 2026. And to further our disappointment, both the AMD and Intel chips with extra cache might not be focused on gaming performance, but AI. Per OneUSMIS, asymmetrical cache performance degradation might not be a concern for AI workloads, so yay, more AI. Speaking of Intel and 2026, there's debate whether the formerly dominant chip giant will even make it that long, and it's tough to tell if US government intervention is helping or hurting. On Tuesday, the Trump administration announced a 100% tariff on semiconductors from Taiwan, purportedly with the goal of encouraging domestic chip production, but Intel notably is also a TSMC customer. It's where all of their current Core Ultra desktop CPUs are fabbed, as well as the Arc Battlemage GPUs, and oh yeah, all the CPUs and GPUs that AMD makes, as well as all those Nvidia RTX video cards as well, so a 100% tariff would be bad news for people in the US who wanted to buy any of those things. But not to worry, it was just a big bluff apparently, and TSMC will be exempted from those tariffs since they have ongoing fab production happening in Arizona. Not sure what happened to the other demands that TSMC buy a 49% stake in Intel, as well as a further, let's ballpark it at $400 billion investment in the US, but at least it provided a brief distraction. The president further assisted Intel on Thursday by publicly demanding CEO Lip-Bu Tan resign immediately because he is conflicted. No specific reason was given, but it was likely spurred by recent news that Cadence Design Systems, where Tan was formerly CEO, pleaded guilty to illegally selling export-controlled American tech to China. So phew, somehow I'm compelled to report on all this stuff, even though I made this tech news series to talk about PC hardware and video games. Nvidia is the other company who frequently forces me to discuss geopolitical stuff alongside PC hardware, and they're currently in a bit of an awkward three-way with the US and China, as discussed last week when China demanded that Nvidia provide an explanation for the US demanding that Nvidia's chips sold to China include backdoors and remote kill switches. We're not exactly sure how that meeting went, but Nvidia followed up Tuesday by posting this article written by their chief security officer, David Reber Jr. Reber minces no words in pointing out the security risks inherent to built-in controls such as these, and states unequivocally that Nvidia GPUs do not and should not have kill switches and backdoors. So that issue is wrapped up in a neat little package, and surely the fact that the White House Director of Science and Technology just brought it up again, or the more than $1 billion worth of Nvidia AI chips that have ended up in China despite the export controls, won't mean I have to continue to bring this up as policies that impact AI chips so often have a knock-on effect to gaming GPUs as well. Speaking of an awkward backdoor three-way, your mom. And wrapping things up with one final bit of news that returns us to a focus on PC hardware while also being warm and comforting in its consistent, steady progress, PCI Express 8.0. I know, you just barely got version 5, but 8.0 was officially announced Tuesday by the PCI SIG Consortium, which I always picture as that big Deus Ex Machina face thing from the end of The Matrix. Their goal is to double bandwidth every 3 years, and PCIe 7.0, which supports 128 giga transfers per lane or 512 gigabytes per second bidirectionally via a full x16 connection, was finalized on June 11th, 2025. So as you'd expect, PCIe 8.0 does 256 giga transfers per lane and 1 terabyte per second with a x16 connection, and they expect to finalize it in 2028. A terabyte per second may be predictable, but it's still pretty damn impressive, although as you might have noticed, products based on these specs take a good few years to come to market. Nevertheless, I found this to be a nice, grounded palate cleanser after some of the other fare that we've been offered this week. But there you have it guys, tech news for the week, and if you liked it, click that like button or leave me a comment down below. While you're down there, all of the articles I talked about today are linked in the video's description if you're interested, and you can check out my store at paulshardware.net for high quality merchandise, t-shirts, hoodies, beer sets, and more. Subscribing to my channel is always a good call too. Thanks again everyone, and remember, no tech news next week, the show returns August 17th.